Welcome back to the Fuji Guys. My name is Francis. So if you're like me and you were pretty excited when you heard about the development announcement of X-Raw Studio, the software that would actually give you the same color and image quality that you would get from the in-camera JPEG but working on your computer, well, today Fujifilm just released it. So if you want to know more about this software, keep on watching. So first of all, you want to open up the camera and then go into connection settings and set it to USB raw converter backup restore, and then you want to connect the camera to the computer. There we go, and now we are ready to start working. So you are going to open up Fujifilm X-Raw Studio. And as you can see, the Fujifilm GFX 50S is connected to the computer. So what that will do is actually, I'm going to work on my files on my computer, and then it's going to send the file whenever I export it to the camera, and it's going to bring it back into the computer with the JPEG file. So I have here on my external hard drive, but it could be on your SD card or whatever drive, and then you open up the folder that you want. I personally go and make the selection of my photos and then put them in the folder, and then I can work on them on the X-Raw Studio. So what's really interesting is that, you know, whenever you import your files into Lightroom or Bridge or something, they always come flat, you know, as the no adjustment on them. What's really cool with X-Raw Studio is actually it keeps the settings from when you shot your image, and it shows you right there on the right panel all the adjustment that you had when you took the shot. So from there, let's just do a little walk around the software. So if you go up there, you have your battery level from your camera. You have your source image folder, so wherever you want to get your images from. You have your histogram here, and then you have all your metadata image information right here. If you go there, you have your single screen, or you have your before and after. Let's just put it back to single for now. And then you have full view, or you can zoom in to 100% or whatever you want, and then you can move around and make sure you had focus. Now, if you want to actually full view, the other way you could do 100% right here, and you can come back to the full screen there. You can actually select to zoom by stages. And again, I'm gonna go back here. So you really have all the basic tools to work on your exposure on your image. And this is really more convenient than working in the camera itself. I used to go into the RAW converter inside the camera and do all my images because I didn't like the rendering that I would get from Photoshop or Lightroom. Not because it's not good, just because it couldn't recreate the exact same tones and colors from my X-Series camera or GFX camera. So let's go back in there. So you can either display or not display the JPEGs here. I don't have any in this folder, but I always leave it at that because I don't want to work on the JPEGs. So let's just take an image, for example. So I have this one here. So since I have the GFX, I could export it to TIFF if I wanted. Personally, I like JPEGs better. And then you can go and change the ratio of your image, just like you would into the camera. So let's put it, for example, at 1:1 there. You have your image quality, so super fine. Dynamic range, so it's not available there because it was shot at ISO 100. It is really cool to not have to actually work in the camera and just work on the computer. So moving on, you have your grain effect if you want to go strong, weak. Again, all the same settings that you get into your camera. If the white balance was off, so I could go and put it to daylight, which it should have already. Yeah, that's where it was on the auto. But again, you can go and change it like this. So let's put it back to daylight. There you go. And then if you want to, you can go before and after. So it starts from there, from your main, from when you actually click on the before and after, and then you can go and play and see the before and after on your image. And then just put it to Acros, for example, here. So let's say this image is ready to go. I can just go and convert it. So I click once, that's for one photo. So it's converting it. So if I go back here and show the JPEGs actually, it's right here. So if I want, I can actually batch convert. So I'm just going to take this one and take this one as well. And I can just convert them. So there you go. So now I've just done two, but I can do more than that actually. I could take the whole thing and do it at once. But as you can see, I have my two JPEGs here that I just converted, this one and that one here. And the last thing that's really cool is that, as you know, I like my recipes a lot, so I can actually save them into the software itself. So I could select all of my images and just select one user profile. So let's just go and create one. So if I take a raw image here, so let's take that one. So let's just make a recipe. So JPEG, I want it super fine. I want it in Astia. I want it plus two, yes. I want it plus two. Color minus one. And then sharpness, I don't need to. This is a GFX. So I can just save profile and then call it Astia. So, sorry about that. Astia, right here. So if I take, for example, another image, let's take this one, I can apply the Astia profile. And then I can make further adjustments from there. So this was a little bit underexposed, so I'm just going to push it half stop there. And then if I'm happy with it, there you go. You can add more if you want. So let's say we're going to create another one from this. So pro negative high. And then let's push the shadow. And then, yeah, so let's just save this one. Pro negative shadow plus four. There. So as you can see, they stack up there. So there you have it, a little overview of the brand new Fujifilm X-RAW Studio. And I hope this was useful. And if you should have any questions, please leave them in the comments section down below. And if you want to know more about Fujifilm products, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on Twitter and Instagram. And until the next time, c'était Francis pour les Fuji guys.